Rest in peace, Shad Gaspard. He was an amazing person, amazing dad, amazing athlete, and an amazing human being. I've interviewed a few times, and he was always with a huge smile, very friendly. Anyone who ever met him right away took a liking to him. He was just a very cool dude. He was in the WWE for 8 years. He was a professional boxer, professional MMA fighter. And as of late, he used to go a lot to Churchill Boxing and spend a lot of time training his son. But unfortunately, this is a very tragic story. Last Sunday, he was at Venice Beach here in Los Angeles. He was in the water with his son, and they got caught up in a rip current. He did everything he could to save his son's life, which he did. He held his son until the lifeguard was able to come and save his son. And unfortunately, he got swept away, and he passed away. Very, very tragic. He did the ultimate sacrifice, saving his son's life. And it's just a tremendous loss. Shad was just a person that everyone loved, just full of positivity, never bad, never negative, never had anything bad to say about no one. Always very, very positive. So rest in peace, Shad. I know all your friends miss you. I know your family's hurting, and you will be missed. Here's an interview. Here's a kid, he's a WWE fan. He asked Shad if he ever fought against John Cena, and he said, no, we were teammates. But check out, here's an interview I did with Shad.
What's the other thing? I did switch from, I was fighting MMA in combat sports, and then I was WWE. So my switch was the reverse.
That's
so
weird.
I already made my switch. It wasn't weird, because when I was fighting, there was not enough money to keep me in the fighting. You know, it was either I stick with boxing, and I didn't like just punching, and or I fight overseas in Pride and stuff like that, where even the money wasn't that good anyway. So WWE is the best option for me.
And now, would you want to go back and fight in the UFC?
No.
Like, who do you think you could take out in UFC right now?
Nobody.
Why?
Nobody.
King of the ring.
Yeah, I know. That's Tyrone Spong, man. I'm just not that guy no more, man. When I was fighting, I was just a kid, just wanted to fight. Now I'm a father. Now I'm a businessman. I got things to lose. Before, I had a one-bedroom apartment with ramen noodles. You know what I'm saying? I'll fight anybody because I was hungry. Now I got things that I like.
Best pound for pound in MMA, best pound for pound in boxing today.
Today?
Yeah.
The best pound for pound?
That's
it's a couple guys I like, but
he should quit over.
I'll give Jones and Cormier best pound for pounds for boxing, Floyd Mayweather, of course. You know what? I'm not stupid. I follow patterns. I love math. And the pattern is Mayweather constantly winning. I'm not going against him. I'm just letting it go. I'll be like, yo, maybe they don't like it.
So, Jack, you have tons and tons of fans for your WWE days.
Yeah.
They all remember you.
Yeah.
What did they tell you? Like, I'm sure they're fans of you from back then.
I don't even know them. I want to know.
Well, I know you're from WWE. Yeah. Did you fight John Cena ever?
Yeah, I wrestled John Cena. Huh? I wrestled with him. He's on my team. We won. Yeah.
He wrestled with John Cena.
Yeah.
Do you miss those days, though, of being WWE?
You know what it is? I think forward, so I don't miss things in the past. I look forward to the future. You know what I'm saying? So, like, the things that I do miss, I still have. My brotherhood, my boys. That's the main thing, you know what I mean? So
I've been a fighter my entire life, but wrestling is more about durability. You know, we take bumps on our back, on shoulder, arms. So when a wrestler gets kicked in the side or the hip or the stomach, it doesn't have as much impact as it would on a normal fighter because we've been kicked and hit so many times. It just doesn't, you know, flow right.
Who are your favorite fighters in the world today?
Oh my God. Today or in general?
Both.
I'm a fighter.
Okay.
You know, so I grew up watching films of, you know, Max Beer. I love the fact what Jack Johnson did as a fighter, but he's also an amazing, like, he's just awesome, like, interesting guy to read about.
Congress just cleared his name after 100 years, right?
Really? Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
I literally just had like four guys try to offer me a fight. They're like 6'9 fighter, and then when they find out who I was and how good I was, they're like, oh, we should manage you. I was like, dude, no. I'm 32 years old. I got a son. I'm chill, man. You know what I'm saying? That's what my father wanted when I was younger. I had a different plan.
If people want to follow you on Twitter, where do they go?
Shad Beast.
There you have it. Shad Beast. FinishingReporting.com. I'm Money Sick Back Reporting.